Hey, what's up everyone? I'm Tavleen from Build WooFunnels and I am super excited to be doing this video because today we're talking to Blake Rudis, who's the founder of F64 Academy, and he teaches people photography and Photoshop. Well, he's great at his craft, but he was really struggling with the limitations of WooCommerce until he found out about Build WooFunnels. So this video is really about that journey, about that transformation from calling his cart a mess to being in a place where he is super proud of the checkout experience that he has created. So let's go in, and yes, we will also be exploring the numbers.
My cart was a mess. So I started off trying to maximize my profit in the end. And this is kind of where I wound up with WooFunnels too, is that I am always about maximizing my profits so that no other company is taking money from me that I should be receiving for my products.
Sure.
So recently I've been doing my launches, and my funnels have gotten bigger and bigger and thicker and thicker. And WooCommerce alone doesn't really do it. So I build a lot of my own standardized pages, lots of coupon codes, lots of headache in order to not have to go with some of the other brands out there.
Right.
Whereas, as we know, some of those other brands are charging, you know, sometimes $300 a month.
Yeah.
Well, if your store, and you're just starting out and you're only making $2,000 a month in your store, $300
that's a big chunk.
Yeah. 15% profit is going to some other company just to run your checkout. So as I was researching different ways of building funnels, I came upon WooFunnels and thought I'd just go on a limb and see if I could get it going for my last launch and see if it would work out. And it was phenomenal. I mean, obviously you guys have a really great price point where it's not about price gouging the individual. So
Could you talk about some sort of numbers or some sort of conversion rates? We could go there, like in terms of, what were you doing before you implemented the checkout solution by Build WooFunnels, and after you implemented Arrow, like how things shifted. So if you could just talk a bit about it.
Sure. So the biggest thing is, as far as launches are my thing. I like funnels, and funnels are great, but launches are key and critical for me. And with a launch, you want as little exits as possible for the buyer. So the exits being ways that they could get away from the sale. So on your page, you want your launch page to basically only either, the only way they can get out is pressing the X or by buying your product.
Yeah.
If they go to buy the product and that takes them to their cart, now there's another exit. And then if that goes from the cart to the checkout, that's another exit. And then, so I'm all about reducing the amount of exit points in the launch.
Sure.
So with the checkout, it goes right from the launch page right to the checkout, and it's beautiful. So that's the big thing with me, is the beauty of that checkout page. Because a regular WooCommerce checkout page, I don't care how good you are, they all look like crap. You know, just unless you're doing some type of way of plugging into that checkout experience, it's plain. And you know, it's I equate the checkout experience to what your experience is like when you walk into a store. And there's a reason why certain stores are more successful at that checkout than others. Their checkout up front is friendlier, it looks better, it makes you, you know, feel more comfortable when you're doing it. And then also the most successful stores, obviously at their checkout, they're gonna do some type of way to get that, either get you to buy a candy bar or something.
Absolutely.
Right there. So I equate the checkout experience to how clean my customer service looks on that initial purchase. And that's key. And then the order bump is, you know, what they buy on their way out. So with the in the past, I wasn't doing any order bumps at all, because you couldn't implement it with a regular WooCommerce checkout.
Correct. Yeah.
That was the one thing that I was the most intrigued by, and I wasn't sure how it was going to go for my launch.
Yeah.
So when I first implemented it, I had two stages of my launch. One was to current buyers of the product that were buying an upgrade, and the other was to mass public, essentially, that had never seen the product before. So on the order bump alone, there was a 45% order bump purchase for the customers that were buying the upgrade, but then buying the order bump because it was an attractive order bump. During the launch to the general public, I thought that was going to be significantly lower. I was expecting 10 to 20% if I was lucky. And that ended up being 38%.
Wow.
So, you know, that could be the difference of, you know, a five-figure to a six-figure launch. Easy.
Absolutely. Right now, I think, you know, if you go and take a stock of the internet, you'll find a lot of stores who are not doing the order bumps at all. Mm-hmm. What really caused that, you know, sort of that mindset shift in you to actually go ahead and explore order bump and see if it will work for your business or not in the first place?
It was funny because I was actually buying another person's book. Can I say names on here?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Yeah. So it's important because I was buying Russell Brunson's book on, what was that book? It was Expert Secrets. Right. So phenomenal book, great book for anybody who's even wanting to pursue this stuff. But in his checkout, he had an order bump that was, here's your book that you're buying, but you can buy the audio book for $37.
Great,
yeah. So here I was buying a book for $10.
Yeah.
And then I see the order bump for $37. I was like, well, I kind of want the audio so I can listen to it as I drive.
Correct.
So I bought the order bump and that, so I got the book and that's great to have as reference, but I ended up using the order bump more. So right there, I started to think to myself like, well, the order bump can be a scam or the order bump can be used to make a very effective product for somebody that's going to add more value to what they've already purchased.
That's right.
So it just depends on you as, so I sell photography courses. So if I'm selling someone a course on sharpening their photos or something like that, the last thing I want to do is give them a sharpening photos ebook order bump. You want something that's kind of complementary that's going to help out, that gives them a really good opportunity to buy in on something that they won't get at any other time.
Well, next up, let's talk about Blake's order bump. It's a $37 product. And well, he sent us a copy. I sent him another version of it. He put that into play and guess what? That order bump converted at 43%. Out of 156 people in total who bought from him during the launch, 67 people bought the bump offer. That's $2,479 extra from a little bump there with just about 4 to 5 lines of bump offer copy. This result is indeed phenomenal. Let's hear him spill the beans and tell us more about how this happened.
I had just started. So it was funny because I had left a comment on your Facebook page and then you reached out to me and said, thanks for the comment. And then I sent you my checkout because I was really proud of what I just built. It was the first one I ever done. So you had seen the order bump and you said, hey, check out this copy or do you mind if I give you some more copy? And that was great. So I didn't have any copy running. I didn't have that running before. So I couldn't do any A/B testing with it.
Sure.
But I know enough about copywriting to know that what I wrote wasn't really good. I'm a very data-driven person.
Right.
So I tend to write in a data-driven way. And the only other people that are really going to gravitate towards that are data-driven people. So you had done something that was more curiosity-driven and matter of fact. And the copy just seemed to flow better as far as if you're going to offer a one-time offer, data driven might not work because they don't have time to think about it.
Right.
So what you want to do is you want to give something that's just intriguing enough that they want to buy into it. So I read your copy or put it right next to my copy. And I was like, well, if I'm going to buy my product, I'm not going to buy it from this one. I'm going to buy it from this one if I'm given the chance. So I just went ahead and put your copy in there. I was going to A/B test it, but I didn't really feel the need to because I knew that one was definitely better than the other. So
that's great. So you had a 45% conversion rate on that one, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah, that's great.
I got a buddy of mine who I just turned on to WooFunnels who just did his own launch with this as well.
Okay. Great.
He had an issue. He's a much bigger list than I am, but he had an issue where it was doing the spinny thing and I guess his checkout page was being cached. So once he uncached his checkout page, it ran fine. So the support is top of the line. I was just talking to him yesterday, actually, and he goes, you know, I'm glad you turned me on to Aero Checkout. Just did a launch with it. It went phenomenally. And I reached out to their support, and within 10 minutes, I had an answer. And that's awesome because you don't find that these days.
Yeah.
Even for me to leave a review on your Facebook page, you to reach out to me and just to say thank you on Facebook, that's phenomenal. I mean, the support, even when I didn't have an issue, just making sure that I was happy with the product. I mean, that's good customer service. That's another thing too, is you want to build that trust and authority. Good customer service does that. Cause I mean, you guys have a buyer for life with me, so you don't have to worry about that.
That's great to hear that. So especially coming from you, it's amazing to hear that.
All right, so I really hope you enjoyed watching this video and meeting Blake Rudis in this video. Well, so just to conclude everything, it is very important for you to have a highly optimized, clean checkout experience that makes your customers fall in love with your brand and really trust it. Well, that's exactly how you build a lot of trust and rapport with your customers. Secondly, the most important thing, you really want to have an order bump on your checkout page, because this really is like going to a grocery store and buying some chewing gums or candies on your way out. It's as simple as that. When you translate it into the online world, the only difference being, well, these candies can cost up to $37, $47, or, you know, even more than $50. And that's just great. When you add up all the numbers, well, it can significantly impact your bottom line and increase your average order value. So you really want to be writing those 4 to 5 lines over there in your order bump section, encouraging people to take up on the bump. It's an AOV boosting move for sure. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Well, if you did, please leave a comment, like and share this video, and do not forget to go over to buildwoofunnels.com to find out more about how you can implement a sales funnel solution in your WooCommerce store. I'm absolutely convinced you're gonna love what you see. Goodbye.